knows my name. He knows my name. Yes, he knows my name. And oh, how he walks with me. Talks with me, yeah. And oh, how he tells me that I am his own.
God. We thank you for your love, your grace, your mercy. We thank you, God, because of who you are. We know, God, that you are in control of all we do, all you see, all you hear, God. But right now we come on our sister Yogi's behalf. We're praying right now, God, that you, we know you as a healer. We know you as a healer, God. I know her situation, God, and I know you know her situation. I know, God, that you have her on your mind. I know, God, that you know her name. You know what, who she is. You know the importance of her gifts on the inside. So right now, in the name of Jesus, we're claiming healing over her body, God. Not just healing over her body, God, even emotional, spiritual, financial, God, healing in every area, God, that you're going to make a miracle out of her. God, we love you for who you are, what you are to us, God. And so right now, God, we start praising you for the victory. We start praising you for the love. We start praising you, God, for everything that you have purpose for us to do. We praising you, God, for how you have purpose for Yogi to go through things, God, to test her strength. Now, God, she has been proven by the fire. So, God, we ask right now, God, that you squeeze the anointing out of her, God. You get all of the anointing all out of her, God. So now, from this day forward, God, she walks with victory. Even in everything that she touched, God, it considers the idea of healing. Even when she's not thinking about healing, God, it flows naturally through her, God. So right now, God, we thank you and we praise you in the name of Jesus for who she is, what she is going to become, and how you're going to use her. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Good morning, my coffee and conversation family. Good morning to you. We pray right now that you all have rested well last night. And we know that God is a good God. We know that God is a good God. He's more than a good God. I call him a great God. I do hope you all have rested well. I pray that you all have rested well. I have a conversation. Let me say good morning. Good morning, Tony. Good morning, Jackie. Good morning, Yogi. Did I miss anybody? Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, Wanda. Thank you all so much for joining this morning on Coffee and Conversation. Good morning. Yesterday, last night, I was engaged in a conversation, and this jumped in my spirit, and I had to write it down to make sure I'm able to have this conversation with you all this morning. It's real good. It's real good. Like this coffee that I'm drinking, real good. The thought is this. Stop looking for signs and just trust what you hear. Stop looking for signs and start trusting what you hear. And I guess I should have gotten up earlier and found it. There's a Bible verse that talks about the maturity of a Christian, or the maturity of your relationship with God. The maturity in your spiritual walk. That's what I should have said. It talked about the maturity of your spiritual walk. The scripture told us that only basically the immature Christian asks for signs because his growth has not reached the mature level that older or more mature Christians has reached. In other words, because I have not tested God, I have not grown with God. My walk is not as strong as it's going to be. Not that it's not. It is, you know, you still had to reach a certain level. It says that those Christians has to keep asking for signs. But for the mature Christian, they lean and they live their life by faith. The Bible tells us we walk by faith and not by sight. We walk by faith and not by sight. I don't have to see much. I just have to believe. I always say it like this. You have to believe down in your shando that if God said it, he's got it. If God's going to put me through something, I'm on his mind. Have you considered my servant, Job? He literally asked Satan, have you thought about Job? Try him. Why would Jesus make this statement? He said, what are you doing up here? The enemy said to God, I'm literally going back and forth to see who I can devour. We go through tests. We go through tests and we go through things really for the testing of our faith. Beyond going through tests, we get things down in our spirit. We feel God down in our spirit. God gives us ideas. God gives us plans. God gives us, thank you, Yogi. Thank you so much, Yogi. 1 Corinthians 14 and 20. God shows us things concerning your life, concerning my life. See, I have this. I'm foolish enough to believe that because God showed me certain things in my life, because God has shown me certain things in my life that I was supposed to accomplish, there is no way I can die. There's no way I can die because he showed me that I'm supposed to be doing that, that he's going to use me to accomplish something. And since he showed me that, nothing can happen to me. He has to protect me. He has to protect me. And because he has to protect me, I have to, but see, here's the thing, ladies and gentlemen. If you believe him, it makes me ignore all of the stuff that I see. Because I have faith in what God showed me in my spirit. My spiritual eye saw this. However, my natural eye sees this. My bank account, my relationship status, and the list goes on and on and on and on. And I see with my eyes natural things that does not match. It does not match what I saw in my spirit. My natural eye and my spiritual eye are at odds with each other. So I have a choice that I have to make. Who do I believe? That's the importance. Listen, I want you all to get this part right here. That's the importance of feeding your spirit man more than you feed your natural man. That's the importance of feeding your. It's important that our spirit man is more powerful than our natural man, because we need our spiritual eye more than we need our natural eye. I'll say that again. We need our spiritual eye more than we need our natural eye. You remember the upper room and Jesus is came back. You know, he said in 3 days I'll arrive. And sure enough, 3 days went by, and he showed back up on the scene. And one of his disciples was talking to him, and he said this to them, because they didn't believe it was him. Stretch forth your hands and put your hand in the hole. I want you to put your hand here. But he said, blessed be to you because you can see it and you can feel it naturally. But down the line, we are down the line now, they don't have the privilege to put their hands in my hole. They can't reach out and feel it in right there when they nail me right here in my wrist. They can't feel when they nail me in the wrist. They can't feel it, the hole that was in, pierced, where they pierced my side. They can't feel that because they have to believe that it truly happened. In other words, they're going to have to use their spiritual eye and believe. My brothers and sisters, I ask you all to consider the thought of simply trusting God with your spiritual eye. God showed you something. I'm talking directly to each and every last one of you. Even to those that are may come back and listen to it later. Wanda, I'm talking to you. Yogi, I'm talking to you. Tony, I'm talking to you. Jackie, I'm talking to you. I think I got everybody that's in the group. That's in the group chat right now. I'm talking to each and every last one of you. I'm literally talking to each and every last one of you. God showed you something. Yeah, I paused there for you all to bring it to the top of your head. God showed you something. I double dog dare you to start praising God for what he showed you and that he's going to do through you. I double dog. You may not. I dare you to start saying, God, thank you for allowing me to do this as if it was already here. Thank you for allowing me to be this. Thank you for allowing me to do that. Thank you for using me to become this. I dare you. It's not here. I'm not talking about that thing that you're already working in. Because I guarantee you, God showed each and every last one of you something that has not arrived. And it's bigger than your bank account. It's bigger than your resources. It's bigger than your education. I double dog dare you to start thanking God for you being that. Not that you are that, but that God has considered you, and because he has considered you, he's going to make it happen for you. I dare you to start praising God for it. When you walk by your spiritual eyesight, your physical condition changes. Let me help you out. When you walk by your spiritual eyesight, your natural condition changes. What you're going through changes. Here's why. If something happens to me, you know that it is part of the plan. I'll say that again. If it happened to you, it is part of the plan. If no matter what the situation is, if it happened to you, connected to being a part of the plan. Whether we're talking about the conditions of our nation today, of this world today, whether it's the COVID virus, because we're living in Jumanji right now. I don't care what nobody say. This is Jumanji. I just wish somebody win the game, so the man in the truck could come and let everybody go back home. But I still consider that whatever is going on in my life today, no matter what it is, I consider it to be a part of the plan. It has been a struggle for many people, mentally, physically, this year, but we can continue to do what God has purposed for us to do in the midst of it all. God will bless us and everyone connected to us. You better believe that. When I go through a financial struggle, it's teaching me something. When I go through a health struggle, it's teaching me something. When I go through an emotional struggle, it's teaching me something that directly affects where God is taking me. It came on maybe three times, probably done watched it three times. Karate Kid, the one with Will Smith's son, the last one that was made. And it was the same thing with the old Karate Kid. He made him take off his jacket, throw it on the grill, pick up his jacket, hang it up, take the jacket off the thing, put it on, throw it on the floor. And he kept repeating that cycle. Will Smith's son's character, gets frustrated and said, "I'm tired of doing this. I'm tired of having to go through this, and I'm not learning anything. You're not teaching me karate. You're not teaching me anything, and you're not a teacher. And because if you was a teacher, you would have taught me something by now." Mr. Han calls him over. Jackie Carriage's character calls him back with a deliberate voice and makes him stand. And he started calling out the command, pick up the coat, throw the coat down, hang up the coat. As he called out those commands, he used what he was doing to show him the karate moves that he learned. He showed him the exact karate move that he learned by hanging up a coat, throwing down a coat, picking up a coat, putting on a coat. It was frustrating for the kid to have to keep going through that and not know why. Mr. Han told him that, "I'm going to teach you karate, kung fu." When he put him in that situation, a defensive or a karate situation or a fighting situation, he learned that everything that he was going through had something to do with him fighting. Watch this. At the end of the day, at the end of this movie, and at the end of your day, at the end of your life, you would have won. He ended up winning the entire battle karate tournament off of picking up the coat, throw down the coat, put on the coat, hang up the coat, take off the coat, throw the coat down. Because what he didn't understand then, he used to win the tournament. I suggest to you all that if you take what you don't understand of why I'm going through this, why I got to do this. See, I guess, for me, I've already had my argument with God. People sit there You don't argue with me. Yes, I've yelled at God. I've said some words to God that I know I have to answer to. I know I have to answer to it from him. I know I have. I know I'm going to have to answer for a few conversations I've had with him. But I got frustrated. I got frustrated with the lessons, with the things that I was going through. And because I was using my natural eye more than I was using my spiritual eye, I didn't see the value of throwing down the coat, picking up the coat, hanging up the coat, putting on the coat, putting off the coat. I didn't see the value of that. But now, ladies and gentlemen, my gift is now taking me places that I never thought I'd be in. It's allowed me to sit at the table amongst bishops, amongst senior leaders, and my voice counted, and recognized that my voice counts for something. My friends, I ask you this, and I make this statement again. Stop looking for signs and trust what you hear or what you saw spiritually or what God told you. Stop. Don't worry about the signs. Don't worry about, okay, God, because I was like this. Okay, if I'm going to help y'all out because I got to come to a close right here. If God, if you want me to do that, make this do this. In the biblical days, they would say, okay, God, well, make it do this. If that's you, God, make it do that. My friends, this morning, I simply say this. The God is a great God. He's even better when we fully trust him. God is a good God, but he's even better when we fully trust him. That's a postable quote right there. Y'all can go ahead and put that on y'all social media. God is a good God, but he's even better when you fully trust him. Thank you all so much. Thank you all so much. And we're praying for healing. And we're praying that God adjust things right now. And especially with Yogi, that God start doing this change in you. And Yogi, I know where you are, dear. I know what you're going through. And when we get off, I ask that you all that, and I know you all have already connected in prayer with Yogi, but I want all of my listeners to, when we get off, that you all make sure that you pray your own personal prayer, because some of you all have gifts of healing in your prayers to the max of what Yogi needs. Right now, and we know that God is going to answer her. Y'all make sure y'all do that. Thank you all so, so much for listening in to me this morning. I do appreciate you all. I do appreciate you all. God is good. I'll catch you all next time on Coffee and Conversation with your boy J-Man on Spreaker.com, iHeartRadio, Spotify, and all the other platforms that we're on. Even Alexa can make it do what it do.
He saw the best in me when everyone else around me could only see the worst in me. I wish I had a witness tonight. Said he saw the best in me. I guess I'm the only one that got this testimony. When everyone else around me can only see the worst in me. Can I tell y'all one more time? I said he saw the best in me. When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me. I wish I had a witness tonight. All I need is one. Hey,
he saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me, yeah.
Everyone else around,
could only see
the worst in me.
Does anybody have that testimony? When folk walked you off, said you would never make it, what did he see?
He saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me, yes.
Oh. When everyone else could only see the worst in me.
Can I tell y'all one more thing? I just need to tell you one more thing. Listen to this. See, he's mine, and I am his. It doesn't matter what I did. He only sees me for who I am. Does anybody know that tonight? Oh, see, he is mine, and I am his. Said it doesn't matter what I did. See, he only sees me for who I am.
Help me sing it.
The girl
said that he is mine.
He's mine.
I'm his.
I'm
his. Said it doesn't matter what
doesn't
I did.
Matter what I did.
He only sees me for who I am.
He only sees me.
Testimony. Help me say it.
He saw the best in me.
Everyone else around me.
When everyone else around could only see the worst in me.
Can I ask y'all one question? The question is simply this. What did he see?
He saw the best.
I can't get no help.